What in the world is happening? I'm Sybert, and this is another Tiberium Wars replay. We are going to be taking a look at Disturbia in the bottom right side of Tournament Arena as the red GDI, and as the yellow Nod, we are going to be having Good Girl, aka Lady Gaga, which I have no idea who this player is, and I don't think I've heard of Disturbia either. So, really don't know what to expect with these two players, but we are going to be seeing fairly similar openers in that they're both going for that Watchtower slash Shredder turret into Barracks and get that Engineer for that Tiberium spike on the north and south sides of this map. And once again, of course, whoa, what in the world? We do have a Shadow Team rush of some sort, which actually, is this going to be the advanced Shadow Team strat? No, it's not. He's going to be going for that Refinery. I don't think he will be going for that advanced Shadow Team strat, which is where you call in your two Shadow Teams, and then I believe you build another Shadow Team. And, oh, wait a second, I think they patched that. And then you sold off the... The Secret Shrine, and you got, like, a fourth Shadow Team, and that was enough to take out a Conyard in, like, two hits, I believe. But we are going to be seeing three Shadow Teams out on the field, going to be sniping a couple of Engineers, one, two, and three right there. So actually going to be sniping all of those Engineers, which is 1,500 credits worth of units that just got taken out. So these Shadow Teams have almost paid for themselves. If they're able to snipe a couple of power plants, that would be a good move as well. Looks like they will be able to get one power plant right there and snipes the... Oh, but the Pibble is out, so good thinking by good Disturbia. Good thinking by not Good Girl, but Good Girl going for a little bit of a fancy strat, able to snipe that one power plant and the Rifleman Squad. And what are all of these Rifleman Squads doing? I guess they're just going to be going on the MCV Killing Spree, which actually they're doing an insane amount of damage. How in the world can mere Riflemans do that much damage to an MCV? I have no idea, but Good Girl, it would be a good idea for him to, or her, to run over these units and stop them from doing so much damage to the Rifleman Squad. But, well, like I was trying to say before the Shadow Team showed up, this is Tiberium Wars. So it does start with Blue Tib on the blue fields, which, goodness, this MCV has taken an absurd amount of damage. Good Girl, you have, what, really? What in the world are you doing? Why are you letting that happen? But he is going to be sneaking one Shadow Team out and then leaving the other one in there, which that is actually a really good idea. But, oh, he does spot it. I'm assuming he does, yes, indeed spot it. He sees that one Shadow Team is going to be going for the gold and sneaking out. And look at that, taking the Conyard down to half health. What in the world is happening? You've had two Harvesters run straight past that Rifleman Squad. What in the world are you doing? We are going to be having a extra power plant not go down. Just a little bit of damage there, which will cost some resources to repair. In the meantime, have they finally taken out the Conyard? And no, well, I don't think the Good Girl really cares at this point, because he's like, hey, you know, if Disturbia kills my Conyard, what in the world do I care? It's just a Conyard. Maybe the Scorpion Tanks? No, they're just gonna shoot at these Rifleman Squads. No, really. Just, Good Girl, what in the world are you doing? This is comical at this point. I do not even understand you, Good Girl. You had better have some crazy awesome strats up your sleeve, because a failed Shadow Team rush, which I don't know if it's really failed. He did shoot, snipe three Engineers, take down a power plant. I mean, that's not necessarily failure, but really? Really, what? What? Who? I can prevent that. Yes, reverse move your Scorpions into them. Finally. Does anyone have a timer on that? I'm really curious as to how long it exactly took Good Girl to finally figure out that, oh hey, I can run over Rifleman Squads. But we are going to be seeing a whole bunch of Pitbulls out of Disturbia, going to be going for those Harvesters, and this is exactly what is a good move. Lots of Harvester harassment is never a bad thing, especially since he was able to clean up those Shadow Teams, and now we are going to be seeing a fair amount of Scorpion Tanks and a little bit of Man Spam coming out of Good Girl, despite the fact that they almost lost their MCV. Good Girl almost lost their MCV, and now the Scorpion Tanks not really working out, needs to get in mass, and Disturbia needs to watch their Pitbull numbers to make sure that they don't lose too many of them. And reverse moving right next to the Scorpion Tanks may not be the best move. Just, you know, running next to Scorpion Tanks, not the best move in general, but actually managing to repair their Conyard back up to nearly full health, and now just figuring out that, oh hey, Scorpion Tanks can run over stuff, just kidding, because I'll just reverse move them into a line of Predator Tanks, which is something I never quite understood why Do players in Tiberium Wars and in also Kane's Wrath always feel the need to reverse move into everything? No matter what, they reverse move no matter what. I never understood it, and it's quite silly. But we are going to be seeing both of these players trading blows a little bit, and I can't imagine that they won't be expanding to that middle ground, although not for Disturbia, choosing not to expand quite yet. MCV is in position, and they do have a couple of buildings queued up, which means that they might be throwing down a refinery just shortly at that midfield. Would not be too surprised to see that, but we are going to be seeing an additional... not really an additional refinery, but an extra refinery down here that could be sold off. And this field up here still at about half health, which means Disturbia has harvested quite a bit more than Good Girl has at this point. But Good Girl does have a far superior army, and Disturbia will get totally owned right here. This is not enough, and even if Good Girl finally figures out, oh hey, I can run over units, that will just help her out even more. If you have a name like Good Girl, I'm going to assume that you're a girl. Statistically, you're a boy, but you're male, but, I mean, come on. But with Disturbia figuring out that she can, in fact, run units over, and she is, in fact, utilizing that power into reverse moving again because, hey, rockets are good on the rear armor, and deciding not to shoot stuff, just to run around, so there must be some sort of massive attack going on up here. Nope, just kidding, because Good Girl wants to take extra damage to her army. But Disturbia finally coming out in force and losing a fair amount of units to that cloaking field from Good Girl. Disturbia trying to make this work and trying to hold the front line, but is it quite working? Disturbia trying to lead the units into that minefield, or just trying to retreat, actually utilizing the reverse move correctly. But it does look like the mines have been spotted, and we do have the sniper team here to lend extra anti-infantry capabilities to make that man spam just a little bit more useless in this situation. But plenty of rifleman squads should be able to lock this down, and with the missile squads here as well, they should be able to... Oh, and the shredder turret comes online just in the nick of time. We should be able to scare off this largely infantry-based... Actually, it's entirely infantry-based army. And even a scorpion tank getting in on the fray, and these rocket troopers should just turn around and shoot it in the face right there. But even more scorpion tanks showing up, so good on Good Girl, able to distract the army and then roll in here with the scorpion tanks and run over the majority of the units from Disturbia. So Disturbia losing the majority of their army to Good Girl, and Good Girl actually doing quite a bit of damage with her scorpion tanks, and now going to be pushing forward with even more, mostly militant squads, which will just get eaten up by those snipers and also the rifleman squads out of Disturbia. Disturbia even throwing down a foxhole or two in the midground will just add to that DPS of those rifleman squads. Throwing down actually three foxholes might even throw in some sniper teams. Oh, actually, look at that. Already throwing some sniper teams into those buildings. Might want to throw a missile squad or two in there as well, just to help hold that midground. And actually, Good Girl would be in a good idea to recap that one Tiberium spike just because. And the scan going down revealing that, hey, this Tiberium field is in fact being harvested. And will that make a difference? I do not think so, because at this point you have to know that that Tiberium field is most likely being harvested, but we are going to be seeing the power go down because probably a tech lab was just built, and what sort of upgrades will Good Girl be going for? Oh, the Black Hand is a pretty good upgrade, and will be able to not do anything because of how many sniper teams there are, at least. There's three up there, which would make five, I do believe, at the minimum. Five sniper teams total, and reverse moving scorpion tanks because that's what all the cool kids do, and not that there's a whole lot there to shoot them. It does look like Disturbia may get seemingly overwhelmed, especially with the Black Hand being able to just take out those garrisons absolutely no problem, and just so many militant squads from Good Girl. She's just doing massive amounts of damage with pure infantry despite some early game flaws that she had in her plan. But was that a juggernaut? Yes, that was, and juggernauts can be so extremely powerful versus infantry, and actually sonic emitters as well. But now when they're powered down, and even when they aren't, they should be able to clean up these infantry, or at least do quite a bit of damage. There is just too much infantry and needs to be focus firing. We'll be able to take out way more infantry and lower that DPS from the non player Good Girl if Disturbia would have focused on the rocket squads, only able to take out one scorpion tank, but in one shot able to take out four or five rocket squads. Going to be going for the power plants to try and drop the power on this sonic emitter. I don't know if that was the best choice, considering how low on life this Sonic Emitter is, but dropping that Operation Center and then selling it, probably a pretty good choice. Another Sonic Emitter does go down, able to do quite a bit of damage. I don't know if, actually at this point, targeting the Avatar is probably the best thing to do, because it wasn't going to be able to take out too much in terms of infantry anyways, but this Harvester might actually be able to do a surprising amount of damage. Can the Juggernauts clean up this army for Disturbia, or will they go down at the hands of the Avatar? Rather the Claws, why are you harvesting this field when you could be eliminating a couple of more infantry squads? One of these Harvesters needs to turn around and take out those missile squads just to keep them out of the fray, unless the Rifleman squads can actually do it. But the Rifleman squads need to be elsewhere doing some shooting on stuff like these Black Hand squads. But just kidding, because the Juggernauts are now down, which means an obelisk has been thrown up to help against the fight, and a couple of watchtowers, I have the feeling, are not going to be quite enough. They will help even the odds and take out some of the Black Hand squads, but a Rifleman squad now at fully epic status, or rather fully heroic status. And the Avatar going to be retreating as the second one does come up, and it's so many watchtowers, it may actually hold here. How is Disturbia even still in this game? Actually, I have to ask myself that about Good Girl as well, as how is she still in this game? Throwing down an extra Shredder turret just to take care of that missile squad, but also the Rifleman squad that was being super pesky right there. And the obelisk, what in the world is it even firing at? I can't even tell you. Going to be going for those watchtowers at this point. Might be a good idea to try and take out that power plant, because I'm not sure how much power the Disturbia actually has. Not a whole lot of money left on the map, but actually a pretty good spread of power plants, but also two MCVs, more importantly, which will allow dual Sonic Emitters, and we still have build radius, and we're still gathering money. Disturbia somehow managing to hold on to these two refineries and two Harvesters as well, should just sell them off right now, but no, instead going to be going for those watchtowers, trying to make something work, and a whole lot of orcas are now showing up to the fight. Going to be going for the Avatars, probably a pretty good choice. Not the best micro on those missiles, but able to take out almost three Harvesters. Just one more rocket on that one Harvester would take it out. Instead, they are going to be going for another Harvester, and so many orcas. Just one more rocket over here to take it out. And will that be it? No, it does look like that husk will go down, though. Good move from Disturbia, though, taking down those Avatar husks and keeping those Avatars from being reclaimed by Good Girl. But now going to be going for those watchtowers. And even the watchtowers might be able to take out the Avatar, just kidding, because they are outside of that attacking range. But now all of the militant squads have gone down, and this Avatar steps inside just a little bit, and that one single Avatar that was just one hit away, surviving way too long, needs to take out the Hand of Nod so that they do not lose any more orcas. Disturbia going to be going into the backside of this map to take out, I can only guess, this probably the Harvester, and then going for the power plants to try and cut the power on the obelisks, but also slow production would not be a bad thing at this point. Even one watchtower still stands with about 60% of its health, and this match actually turning into a pretty awesome, fun, exciting match that has been going on. But does look like Tiberium Infusion is done, which I believe that it grants them immunity to Tiberium, but also I believe a damage bonus. Oh no, movement speed and hit points. So actually going to be moving in with a couple of more shadow teams, trying out that again. Were they actually able to do anything? Not a whole lot. Able to do a little bit of damage there, but I don't think they were able to do too much. And we do have another massive man spam, and even got the Confessor leaders, which of course Confessor's pretty darn good anti-infantry, but what in the world are all of these Harvesters doing? Are there any war factors? Because you could send the Harvesters back to the war factory and then use them to run over all of these infantry. Of course, a very good choice. But, I mean, you know, also letting them sit up here and possibly just get shot up is also a good choice. I'm not sure. Is there typing going on right now? Because neither of these players are doing anything. But Good Girl really needs to be shooting this refinery just now, getting into it. Maybe they were typing some happy, friendly things to each other, but reclaiming a Juggernaut husk, that's going to be super annoying. Good Girl now has herself a Juggernaut and going to be taking out that armory as well. And now a couple of watchtowers are down. Unfortunately, oh hey, we actually have a commando. Have I ever seen a commando? What in the world? And a stealth tank as well. This game is all sorts of wonky. But, like I was saying, this is not Kane's Wrath, which means no AP ammo, which is kind of sad days, but so many of those rocket missiles, militant rocket squads will go down if they're actually able to get targeted by the commando, and the mammoth tank should be rolling up here. I don't know if they would get far enough, but this mammoth tank could have been running stuff over by now, and the commando needs to swing back around under cover of these watchtowers and start doing massive damage to those rocket squads, or he could just chill over here. Commando just chilling in the back and staying out of the way of the fight, but we are going to see another Orca strike over here take out some harvesters, and it does look like even though the tech lab still stands, and actually no upgrades on that tech lab, so it does look like just going to be using that for that tier 3 tech as of right now. And is it going to be sniper teams? I think it will be, because what else would be coming in a set of 3 but sniper teams? I don't even know, but Venom here to spot that stealth, and it is going to take out these sniper teams absolutely no problem, which means all of that money was a complete waste from Disturbia still rocking the 2 MCVs though, and given instant, well, not quite instant, but veteran status, or rather epic status, to that one Venom. And the Pitbull, is it going to be enough? Not quite enough to chase down those Venoms and do the damage. And AA battery going to be going down as well, just to stave off any further any further Venom attacks that may be happening. But we are going to see another very spread out man spam attack. We are going to see quite a few rocket squads, but they're so spread out, I don't know how effective they'll be. As you can see, all of the ones up here got taken out, while the ones in the back aren't really doing a whole lot. Maybe this militant squad right there could at least be taking some shots for the rocket squads, which are the ones going to be doing the actual damage to the units, or not to the units, but rather to the buildings. And I think Disturbia has an advantage. Good Girl had an advantage. Disturbia had an advantage. This game back and forth basically constantly, and almost action from the beginning, almost. Just a slight slowdown in the beginning, and the shadow teams hit, and it's basically been non-stop running ever since then. Somehow both of these players have managed to hold on to their Tiberium towers. You'd think at this point that one of them would have taken them out, but not so. They are both being super manner to each other and not taking out those Tiberium spikes, which I'm sure it's less of a manner issue and more of a I'm just not thinking of it. But oh, a Sam Turret goes down and gets basically the perfect placement. Good on Good Girl, able to get 2 volleys off. Basically, no, just kidding, 3 volleys off with those Sam Turrets, because Disturbia is not paying a lot of attention. 4 volleys off and throwing down another Sam Turret. Disturbia just can't catch a free couple of kills with these Orcas, but going to be getting a couple of shots off there. And is it enough? No, it will not be enough to actually take down any more Orcas. But taking down 2 or 3 Orcas in that engagement there is not a bad place for Good Girl to be in, as Orcas are pretty expensive compared to the relatively cheap, I believe, $800 price tag of those SAM turrets. And will the sniper teams actually be able to do anything? It does not look like there are any Black Hand squads to stop this, which means they will get a couple of free shots before the foxhole gets destroyed. And then after that, they will go stealth until a Venom pops out to shoot them in the face. But it does look like they are outside of the influence of that disruption tower, and an APC going to be showing up just to take a little bit of damage with a commando. And is it going to be able to do anything? If he can sneak in here, he will be able to do massive damage. Is there, and it's not a whole lot to stop him. And move forward, Disturbia. What in the world are you doing? Somehow able to see that. Am I missing something? I thought that that was supposed to be stealthed by, oh no, the sniper team would reveal that. But actually a pretty good hit and run by Disturbia, able to take out the air tower and stop any more Venom production. And is this going to be it for Good Girl? I don't know if she has anything. Oh, just kidding, because the commando gets taken out. Yes, jump jetting at just the last second and then dying in midair and flying halfway across the map. Good play by Good Girl, stopping that commando in his tracks. But the commando did do quite a bit of damage, taking out the forward outpost that was up there, that airfield and a couple of other buildings as well. And now an Orca strike going to be on the way. Is it going to actually hit the harvester? No, it is far from actually dropping those credits in. But both of these players somehow still holding on to their Tiberium spikes. Just kidding, because Good Girl should recap that, or should cap it very quickly. And then we are going to be seeing a couple of more shadow teams just running around trying to do damage, needlessly losing quite a few shadow team members right there. But we are going to be seeing Firehawks, I'm guessing, take down some some Venoms, but I'm not really sure what happened there. We are going to be seeing Orcas over here. I wouldn't be surprised just to see them shoot up some buildings to try and just take stuff down. Looks like they're going to be searching for some harvesters, but there's nothing there for them to shoot. Firehawks, on the other hand, going to be returning back home, and I think they did have the anti-air missiles going to be taking out a couple of aircraft there. And a couple of more, and, well, at least one more. Nope, it is those same two shadow teams that tried to take out that watchtower. And good girl still not taking that lower Tiberium spike. Could totally recap that for a total of 50 credits a second. Instead, an APC actually going to be sniping that Tiberium Tower 4. Tiberium Spike 4, Disturbia, or rather for Good Girl, Disturbia sniping that Tiberium Tower, and then that reminded Good Girl, like, oh, hey, I forgot to recap that, or to cap that Tib Spike. And going to be going for the MCV, maybe no, going to be going instead for, I have no idea what that is, they're just running past everything. I don't know if they actually have enough firepower to take anything down, as I do believe it takes two full squads to take out. No, just kidding, because apparently they do the same damage no matter how many units, how many members are in the squad. But they will not be able to take out an MCV or a war factory. And we are going to be seeing Firehawks taking quite a bit of damage, not actually able to do anything. I'm guessing they stratified it over there and then just kind of died. But the Orc is going to be going down, taking meaningless hits. They should be at least up here doing damage, just kidding, because the Commando did all of that. And is Disturbia going to be able to shut out this game with just the Commando, or will they have to rely on something else? We will wait to see with bated breath, and could sneak the Commando around back over here. Not a whole lot of anti-Commando, although it's kind of hard to be anti-Commando, as even if you're a big tank, can be kind of hard to shoot. But we are going to be seeing a lot of infantry and even a Black Hand being mixed into the mix, mixed into the army to kind of provide an anti, you know, anti-garrison for foxholes, but also another anti-building aspect to it, as the Moroccan squads do a pretty good job of that. But a pit bull going to be spotting for Disturbia and then getting taken out, and an AA tower as well, going to be just sitting there chilling and not really doing anything. But we are going to be seeing a couple of sniper teams get taken out rather quickly. One of them may escape, and we are going to be seeing this. I'm guessing the commando will get jettisoned out of there before that APC goes down. Get jettisoned out of there right then and there, and then jump jet away to safety, and going to be re-engaging here, as that commando can take a little bit of punishment, but not that much. That is going to be pushing forward to do mass amounts of damage, and a epic, and also a heroic squad somewhere in there is going to be a heroic squad, but also an epic, and probably a couple of veteran squads as well. And the mine drop isn't going to be good enough. No, it wasn't getting taken out before any actual mines got dropped. But one MCV may go down, but Disturbia still has another MCV up there, and it does look like Good Girl taking massive damage from those harvesters, finally doing the harvester run over infantry trick that isn't a trick, but going to be going for a couple of units there, not actually able to run over anything, and a couple of pit bulls going to be moving up here to do some damage, and they're just firing at the ground, possibly just a little bit of a bug there. And it does look like the Pibbles are going to be pulling back away from the battle, trying to save themselves. They need to get back and get some repairs. But a single Cabal member, there are no Cabal squads, as this is not the Black Hand, but getting taken out by a sniper team there. Sniper team's going to be moving forward, and no more juggernauts, which means no long-range bombardment, which was always something so fun to do, but it was for the most part completely impractical, as it was quite difficult to actually get a sniper team in position to launch off those shots from basically anywhere. Well, actually not from basically, from anywhere on the map with your juggernauts if you wanted to. But we are going to be seeing an orchestra could completely catch these. Nope, won't catch those harvesters at all, because they stealthed a bit too early for that. But the Orca is going to be escaping. A scan could reveal the harvesters, but the harvesters do get de-stealthed and do get sniped too. Now three have gone down just with this one Orca strike. So good on Disturbia taking down the economy of Good Girl and selling off both a refinery and a Hand of Nod just to get a couple of extra dollars of cash to spend on that army, and still rocking three harvesters almost completely full. So that is going to be 1400 times three, which will be like what, 4200 credits for Disturbia in the cash in the bank. going to be going for, but oh, one Harvester may get taken down. That's 1,400 credits down the drain that you don't quite get back, as the small green Tib spot won't be quite the same, but going to be moving forward with the man spam and even a rocket and even a raider buggy and a couple of attack bikes, rather, not rocket buggies or rocket bikes, but a couple of sniper teams going to be moving up here and getting taken out by those raider buggies, and then the orcas show up to get shot down by the infantry, as you may know that, orcas not very good versus infantry. Infantry, on the other hand, well, at least rocket squads very good versus orcas, and even able to take down one or two there and going to be retreating. But the single APC with the commando once again making an appearance needs to jettison. Oh, just barely did not have to, but he decided to anyways. Disturbia saving the commando from not dying, because he wouldn't have died anyways. A beacon was placed. So good girl apparently being like, hey, I see your commando over there. Or something. I really have no idea why good girl decided to ping over there, I guess just to say, I know you have a commando and I'm going to not do anything about it because I really don't have any forces left. But a scan going down on the other hand, revealing once again another disruption tower, and also this rifleman squad is just like, hey, I'm going to be over here, and good girl completely flattening that one squad. And are we going to see a little bit of Seed Tiberium go down? Yes, right over there, and that was a very good hit with the Seed Tiberium, actually able to put probably, because it does cost 500 credits, which you only need to get half a load of Tiberium out of that to make it worth it. That would give you 200 credits, and wow, Firehawks on that single militant squad. I guess that was just a product of, you know, not micromanaging your units. But instead, we did have a pretty good Seed Tiberium hit, which that will provide probably two or three full loads of Tiberium, which is definitely worth it, as that would be 28 or 4,200 credits worth of delicious Tiberium, and actually going to get taken out there by the commando, that single Tiberium spike for Good Girl, and now Good Girl no longer has any Tiberium spikes, but rather just a couple of more Shadow Teams, and oh, even a Flame Tank getting turned out for this game. And will the Shadow Teams be able to do anything? Probably not, because, I mean, let's face it, it's an APC and that's a Shadow Team. Could he even drop the commando out if he has to, but Disturbia not even having to, and more Orca Strikes going to be moving out across the map, and this game actually turning into a bit of a fun long-term game. Six Orcas now going to be moving out. Are there going to be any Firehawks, and did they happen to spot those Flame Tanks before they stealthed? I do not think so. I think Good Girl stealthed those at just the right time. Going to be splitting up the Orca Rockets, should take down this power plant over here if Disturbia goes for anything, really. Do not need, what? What? You do not need to be spending four bombs. Could have taken out both of those power plants. Instead, only got one. But where in the world did those Flame Tanks go? They are going to be up here. Probably going to be going over here and then swinging around down south, trying to do as much damage as possible, which is actually a really good plan because there's not a whole lot of defense up here. Of course, as soon as the Orcas get wind of it, they will be up in arms and doing massive amounts of damage. No, Zone Troopers! A huge hit, because these Zone Troopers with their jump jets can fly all over the place and do all sorts of crazy damage, but not when they get shot up by militant rifle squads, but they are going to be able to do quite a bit of damage, and the Orcas are here for support. They should be able to take out a couple of Harvesters, no, just kidding, because the Harvesters are stealth, but de-stealthing from the Zone Troopers a little bit there, and allowing the Orcas to do extra damage. Zone Troopers should have taken out that SAM turret, or at least the individual turrets, before the Orcas got there. And now, with the basically the perfect timing, one Flame Tank and the second one is on the way, able to take down one MCV, but does she know that Disturbia has a second MCV in the works? Well, actually not really in the works, but rather just waiting. And this single militant squad getting a fully heroic status, and those Zone Troopers going down, giving out lots of badges and awards to, oh my gosh, these Flame Tanks are doing way too much damage. Orcas, get in the air. You could have taken these out. Losing three Orcas, there was absolutely no reason for that before the Flame Tank finally went down, and the one up here still is at full health. So what in the world happened, Disturbia? You just got totally owned by a couple of Flame Tanks, and when I say totally owned, I of course do not mean totally owned. I mean, he just kind of got killed a lot. But another airfield should be going down quite shortly, as that was basically the biggest advantage that Disturbia had, and really what allowed him or her to do a lot of damage in this game, as Good Girl going to be remassing a bit of a tier 1 army with a couple of tier 2 shadow teams mixed in there, and even some Black Hand from selling off and tech lab, I guess. I'm going to be moving out for Good Girl and Disturbia. Do they have anything left to kind of deal with this or to try and contend in a base race? But an MCV going to be produced for Good Girl, getting that build queue back up and running. And now the Scorpion Tanks are going to be moving out at just the wrong time, or maybe just the right time, reverse moving into those pit bulls, taking a little bit of extra damage from that rear armor. But the pit bulls now going to be trying to run away and launching those rockets as well. And oh, with the mortars, the hits are pretty good, and that was definitely worth those mortars doing quite a bit of damage and damage to those veteran and heroic rifleman squads. But oh, the Black Hand, can they do the damage? No, they're not doing any damage. What are you doing, Black Hand? You need to be firing right now. You could be doing so much damage to those pitbulls. Not actually able to do that much damage, only able to take out one of those pitbulls. Flame Tanks, I know, do an insane amount of damage to pitbulls because they have basically no armor. And this Flame Tank is still just up here chilling, maxing, relaxing, and just not doing a whole lot, just waiting for their time. Disturbia might be able to shut this game out, as they were able to take out the War Factory, which means no more production structures, just the MCV and even the Commando getting in on the action, probably going to insta-kill that Conyard and then force the either fire sale or perhaps a base race. But I do not think that one single Flame Tank can make something happen for Good Girl, and looks like Disturbia may be able to take this game. I don't want to call it too early because I've called it too early in the past and then been completely wrong. I like to think I could call it right now, but still, I mean, Good Girl is going to pull something out of their hat. No, they are not. Good Girl has been defeated. So good game to both of these players, starting out a little bit wonky and with some absurd MCV damage. That was absolutely insane. But man, look at those, that unit graph. Let's just go back to that. Man, Good Girl, what in the world? But on Disturbia, on the other hand, a little bit more even, a little bit more smooth, although still very rocky. Let's take a look at those resources. Almost identical for the first, like, 8 or 9 minutes of that game. Right up in there, very, very close. And in the end, does look like Disturbia was able to get a couple hundred, or a couple thousand more, not a couple hundred thousand, just about 18,000 more resources than Good Girl. And that is going to do it for this cast. I am Sybert, signing out.